Welcome to my kitchen lab. This is where I explore all sorts of weird and wonderful science. I spend a lot of time and have a lot of fun looking at the science behind magic tricks, circus stunts, and many unexpected curiosities. Today, I'm looking at the very first trick I saw performed at a magic show. And if you want to have a go, all you need is a piece of string or rope. Yes. I'm going to attempt, as you are too, to tie a knot in this dangling rope of death using only the one hand, and then we'll investigate the science behind it. This is going to be a fair test, a fair experiment. I'm using just this piece of string. There aren't any trapdoors, mirrors or knots already created, just the appliance of a little bit of science. And not bad, second time lucky. Here we go, I've created what is called an overhand knot. There you go, overhand knot. Let's see how we did that in slow motion. The most important thing is to make sure you keep the rope as still as possible, because if you don't, other forces may affect the motion of it as you're trying to put a knot in it. So I pull it up and around to make this loop. And when I've created the loop, I'm trying to push forwards into the string. And as I do so, it starts to swing through the hole that I've created in the loop. And as it drops because of gravity, it will create a lovely overhand knot. You don't always create an overhand knot. This time I've created what's called a figure of eight knot. Look at it this time, a completely different knot. I really wanted to find out why we get these different knots. Well, this is one solution. As you pull up and create a loop, normally it would go through the loop. But if it goes over and through the loop the other side, I found out you actually create a different type of knot. This is a figure of eight knot. Now, all those other ones must mean that it goes round several times and creates weird and wonderful knots. Now it's time to find some string. Thickness doesn't really matter too much. You want to experiment, of course, but something like that as the thinnest and something like that as the thickest. And then I've got various sizes in between. It's more important that if you hold it, it just falls down like so. There aren't any kinks in it, so it just falls down nicely. They're all made of different materials. That's not really that much important. It might be an experiment you want to do, looking at the frictional effects of the material and whether you can do this. So first things first, how long do you want it? You want it longer than the distance between your hip and the floor. Because when you hold it, that's going to be the rough distance. So the extra bit of string you just wrap into your hand like so. And then when you put it down, you've got the right distance. Then you do nothing. Make sure it's still. And then you just pull it up and around with enough force to create a loop. So you pull it up and around with enough force to create a loop. And then to get that end of the rope through, you've got to push it forwards, and you've got to experiment with how much force. So with all these things, you've got too much force, this is not going to work. So you've got to experiment with the amount of force, and then eventually you'll be able to get a knot just like so. Just to prove it does work with other bits of string, let's try it with the thin one. This was given to me by Mr. String from the Cosmic Goose Juggling Farm in a juggling festival in Hawaii, where I was taught this over 30 years ago. So this is a very old piece of string. So here we go. Mr. String, this is for you. Oh, not bad. First time, Mr. String, I've got a figure of 8 knot, just like that. Isn't that incredible? Now, Mr. String was incredible because not only could he throw a knot of any shape that he asked, he could throw a overhand knot, a figure of 8 knot, all sorts of knots. He could also go, oh, I'm going to do a low knot. I'm going to do a knot here. I'm going to do a knot here. I'm going to do a knot here. And sometimes he would throw this and then do it again and again, and he'd have a sequence of knots going up and down his string. This white one, this was actually just something I found lying around. There's nothing special about this. I'm not sure what you use it for, but I'm sure if anything you have lying around will work. Or maybe it won't. I'm getting excited now. Oh, no, that does work. Look, that's an overhand knot. Final one, this is my favorite one. This is a magician's rope. Magicians use this to do all sorts of their rope tricks. I like it because it's very visual. It's easy to see. A nice feel to it. And let's see how easy it is to do. Oh yeah, very good. How about that? First time creates a very strange, mad knot. If you enjoyed this video, please click like. I have so many more science tricks and experiments to explore, so click subscribe to make sure you find out every time a new one becomes available. Good luck showing your new science magic skill to your friends, and why not teach them so you can start a new craze? You could even amaze your teachers during show and tell by talking about the science of throwing a knot. Until then, remember, practice, practice, and experiment. And then maybe you too can create a knot just like this. See you later.